Hey guys, what's up? Slubson here, and today guys I'm probably bringing you guys my last GTA 5 informational video because GTA 5 does come out tomorrow, which I'm going to be doing first day coverage of. So if you guys want to see awesome GTA 5 coverage and in every area of the map and every area of the game, then make sure to subscribe here on my channel because I'll be doing first day coverage of that and probably all week coverage of that. So in this video today we're going to be looking at the fire department, the police department, and the paramedics and how they will influence your game. Also, wildlife and the fourth character in GTA 5. So, without further ado, let's get straight into this video. So, before anyone starts saying that this is all fake information, it's all bullshit, it's not. I actually got all this information from a subreddit that was on a stream. I was watching the stream and the game looks amazing. It's absolutely amazing game. It looks fantastic. And here are some questions that got asked. Unfortunately, none of mine did. So some of the questions that got asked and answered were ones like these. Do the paramedics heal people? Do the police arrest people? And do the firemen put out fires? And the answer to that is yes. I actually watched one of the fire department put out a fire, and unlike previous Grand Theft Autos, they would actually just sit there in the truck and they would put it out on top of the truck. And sometimes you hit a wall, if there was a wall in front of it, and it wouldn't get put out, which was a bummer back then. But now they actually get out the car and the truck, sorry, and they would go round the wall and use the hose on it, or if they could get it from inside the truck, they want to use the hose on top of the truck. And one good thing about the fire department and the police department, if you ring up and say, yo, I've got someone here that needs to be arrested, or I've got a fire here that needs to be put out, they will come down and they will do it for you, and it gives you some money. I couldn't actually see at the time because I was actually doing something and I just had the stream on in the background, and he said, oh, whoa, I got some money for that, which unfortunately I can't confirm how much money you get. But also the paramedics will offer you healing materials to heal yourself with. If you go up to them and say, I need, can you heal me, and they will give you some health back. So that's pretty cool. So let's move on to the next question that was asked in the live stream Q&A, which reads, what wildlife have you encountered? And as you guys can see in the comment below, that it says he flipped his ride going up to the mountain and he decided to run up the mountain, but instead running up all the way to the top, halfway he got eaten by a cougar. Now that really is cool, and he also seen some deers along the way as well. So we did know that there was some wildlife within GTA. We didn't know how much wildlife. It was loads of different variations of wildlife, or it was just, you know, some deers here and there, some birds, you know, this, that and the other. But we have confirmation that there are different many types of animals and wildlife within the game. So we have cougars in there, so you better watch out if you're going up a mountain. You better take a gun along with you, otherwise you're going to get eaten by a bear or a cougar, which I think is really cool. So let's move on to the next question now, which is a good question. I really thought that they would have included this into GTA 5. It would have been a really nice touch, a really nice feature, so you can listen to your own music. And basically the question is there any custom music stations within GTA 5? And the dude says no, which is unfortunate. I was really hoping to see some custom music stations in there so you could like play music from your PC, your Xbox, or your PS3, which is unfortunate. But you know, as you guys can see there, he says no. But you know, he might have not explored the settings yet of the game to, you know, hook it up to play from your music library on your Xbox, PC, or your PS3. So maybe deep down in the settings we can find a way to do that, which I think on PC you probably could do it. But you know, unfortunately for the console people, it looks like there's no custom radio station. So anyway, let's move on to the next question, which if I'm honest, I probably would not have thought of myself, and it's all about the time scale. The dude says, what is the time scale like in GTA 5? Is it the same as GTA 4 where it's 2 real seconds to 1 game minute? And it's probably the same in older games where it's 1 real second to 1 game minute. Is it the same as GTA 4 or have they changed it? I don't really understand what this question is on about. I know it's not about the time scale, but I don't really get the fact that he's put 2 real seconds to 1 game minute. I don't know what that means, but he's on about 2 seconds to 1 minute for GTA 4 daylight and same for the midnight. I'm not too sure, but if anyone can clear that up for me, then please let me know. And the dude says, and the dude answers this and says, I can't figure it out, but if you watch the stream, then it seems to be a lot longer. So, you know, you guys will be able to go out for longer and not worry about it, you know, the nighttime rolling. You guys have a lot more time to run around in the daylight, but you'll have to take the rough with the smooth and suffer a longer night in GTA 5, which could be a bummer, but it could be an advantage if you're doing missions and you've got to have a long, you know, you're not very good at doing missions really fast, so you're going to have to be a little bit longer. So unfortunately, You're going to have to take the rough with the smooth. If you want longer days, you're going to have to have longer nights. So that's really it, guys, for that question. So let's move on to the second to last question now. And this question is probably my most favorite question, and I pray and thank this dude for asking this question, because little features like these within the game make me happy, because they make me feel like the game has moved forward, and it's just little things like this, they just make me happy, you know. It's like, oh wow, they've added that. It's just something cool and, you know, different to see. But I really enjoy this feature. I hopefully, you know, the multiplayer side will have different phones as well. But basically he says, I haven't seen this question asked or answered yet. So do the three characters have three different phones, or are they all the same? And he says, yes, Franklin has a Samsung Galaxy. He has a question mark at the end of that, so I'm guessing he doesn't really know if it's a Galaxy S or, you know, some other type of Galaxy. I don't really keep up with the Samsung phone market. Michael has an iPhone. This could be the new iPhone that's come out. We're not too sure yet, or it could just be a standard iPhone 5. And Trevor has a Windows phone, which is really good. I really like the fact they have give the characters individual phones instead of just a standard brick phone. So let's move on to the final question now, which wasn't actually asked in the subreddit, which is I found this out literally a couple hours before this, and I think this is really cool that you won't actually play as one of the three characters in the online side of GTA 5. You won't play as Franklin, you won't play as Mike, and you won't play as Trevor. Now, what you will be playing as is your own person. You get to create your own person to play as. You can basically show off what their past was like by what clothes they have and what features they have. So, you know, you might, you know, give some man tattoos all over his body or over his face to show, like, you know, he'd be like in some gangs and stuff like that, maybe. I'm not too sure what you guys will come up with for this, but I really like this feature. I think it's really cool that you can actually make your own person now, so you can actually be a man or a woman in Grand Theft Auto 5, which is amazing. If you guys want to see some GTA 5 online, the day it comes out, which, if I'm correct in saying this, is 2 weeks after the game releases, which is tomorrow. So 2 weeks from tomorrow, you will be able to play GTA online. And if you guys want to see some of that that footage where I get to play with my friends, and I'll be playing with subs, so if you want a chance to play with me on Grand Theft Auto 5, make sure to subscribe and stick around for a video where I say I'm going to be playing with subs on GTA 5. So basically, guys, that is it from me. So if you guys want to stay up to date with GTA 5 and want to see more informational videos, I don't think I'll be doing that anymore actually after this, because GTA 5 does come out tomorrow. But if you want to see some more GTA 5 videos, some awesome videos coming out tomorrow, make sure to subscribe and make sure to like the video if you have enjoyed it. And that is really it from me, guys. And I'll see you guys when I see you guys.